Editing in DaVinci Resolve has never been easier with this. For the past year, I've been editing for creators, and I always wanted something that truly made editing easier for my workflow. I'm sick of every time I have to go back and forth between the edit and fusion page just to make one single adjustment, only to realize it still looks off. So I took all of my editing and coding experience, applied into this, spent over 3 months refining it, making sure every single asset is built to only include the most essential tools that will take your videos to the edge and beyond. This is Creator Flow. My goals here are simple: save you time, remove all the unnecessary work, and making sure it is practical to use. Let me handle all the hard work so you can focus on the fun stuff. So, what's inside? Now we're inside Resolve. First effect that I proudly present to you here is the title effects. Normally with the text plus title, it's really annoying when you have to always go between each page at the top to just adjust one small thing, and it is confusing in terms of the naming of the adjustment. For example, the layout page have this center adjustment, also with the transform page that has this exact same thing, but it's called offset. Not to mention that most of them are useless. So with all these title effects, they are designed to fix that, where you can do every important things in one single page. You can change the fonts, adjust the size, change the color, add some glow, add a border, or even add a 3D shadow, which the normal text plus cannot even do. Then you can add the word outline, and lastly, a drop shadow. Each one of them are fully customizable in one single page. And if you don't have any ideas of how you can design with this title, I also include a preset for you, which is the normal text, where it includes a bunch of versions at the top. Basically, you can choose any version that you like, change the color, and you're good to go. Another one that's pretty cool is this talking line title, where if someone who is not in the camera is talking and you want to show what they're talking about, you can use this title. One of the titles that I use a lot throughout my editing journey is this counting title, where you can set the start and finish number that you want it to count to. Then you can choose between the currency symbol or a percentage symbol. If you wanted to show the number alone, you can choose none. And after that, you can adjust the animation length in frames, where if you set to 30 frames, for example, it will finish the counting at the 30th frame. You can then choose whether you want it to show as a numeric or a compact format. And then the rest are the same as the plain text, where you can add a border, 3D shadow, and etc. One of the titles that pretty time consuming when you have to do it from scratch is this word by word animation. This title is one of the most used titles by creators these days, and it is the one that I spend the most time creating. With this one, you can just type in whatever message you want to show. In the animation page, you can adjust the position where it starts, adjust the animation length, the word delay. So if you make it delay for 10 frames, each word will delay the animation for 10 frames. And then you press the button down below to set the animation. You can then choose the animation curve to your desire. And most importantly, motion blur. It will then look something like this. There are a lot of title effects here for you to try and experiment with, like this wave text, where you can use this title with someone who is talking, for example, with a shaking voice. Or this color shake. One thing with this color shake that you need to keep in mind is you don't want to make it a white color, otherwise the shake effects will not work. And if all of these animations are not enough, I also include over 20 title animations for you, which we will talk about later in this video. I also include a bunch of background for you to use. All of them are some kind of a grid background because I find it the most versatile to use. Each one of them, you can customize it to fit your own branding. Sometimes when you zoom in into your video and want to see the composition, you can just drag and drop this guideline to see whether it is in the perfect place or not. Each and every tool in this pack are automatically resized to any aspect ratio, meaning if you use it with a vertical video, it's still gonna work. And for the ruler, it is inspired by Premiere, where they will have this feature for the user to drag a line and make a custom guideline. So with this tool, you can add a vertical or a horizontal line. Then you can adjust the position of the line, the thickness of the line, as well as the color of the line. For the mask focus, this one is for people who want to focus on something in the video. You can choose between a rectangular mask or a circular mask. Then you can position your mask to wherever you want to make a focus. You can then choose between a center scale or a free scale. Basically, for center scale, it will scale from the middle of the mask. And for free scale, you get to choose where you want it to scale to. Then you can adjust the animation length in frames. Choose the animation curve, adjust how much to scale, how blurry, how dark, and how saturated is your background. You can also add a drop shadow to make it look more, you know, pop out from the video. You can add motion blur if you want to. I also include a bunch of social media motion effects. Here is the sample of it. All of them you can change to your own account name, you can change the color and such, position, and of course, motion blur. Now for the overlay, we have these halftone effects and pixel screen. Let's say you want to add more texture to your B-roll, you can use these too. Now for the title animation that we've mentioned before, we've included over 20 title animations for you to use. Each piece is crafted based on the most used effects in my editing workflow. For example, this sliding 20 frames where it will take 20 frames to slide. Pop-in effects, pop-in and rotate, slide left, slide and break, slide and rotate, zoom out, zoom and rotate, flip effects, and wave effects. You can now experiment with it and combine it with the title in this creator flow. With all the title animations that we have, we of course need to also have some general animations. Normally, you get to create your own keyframes. And if you have used DaVinci long enough, you'll know that the keyframe system in the edit page is trash. You cannot control the curve that well. You don't have the choice to add any motion blur. So I decided to make this easier for you by these general animations. You can add a zoom, slide, or a rotate. Every one of them, you can choose to have an animation in and an animation out, or both. Then as always, animation length, animation curve, the start and finish point, and most importantly, motion blur. Not just that, you can stack a couple of them on top of each other to create a second animation by turning off the animation out of the first one and add a second one, put it at the top of the effects, and then adjust it as you need. Below all the essential animation, we have these bounce and shake animations, which you can combine with the transition by adding it into an adjustment layer, and you can use one of the creator flow transition, for example, if you want to, which of course we'll cover this later on in this video. It will then create these cool effects like when you're seeing a lot of montage video. We also have a lot of blink effects, which is pretty tedious if you have to do it from scratch. Also with these flash effects, if you have to do it frame by frame, tedious. Single flash, where if you create like a 1 second adjustment and apply this single flash, it can create a fake camera flash for you. If you want to quickly create a circle mask, I have it covered for you, where you can choose to use a circular mask or a rectangular mask. Then you can adjust the mask as you wish, the position of the mask, rotation, add a border to your mask. Under these two masks is this green screen keyer. I don't know why DaVinci Resolve doesn't include these effects on the edit page, but basically, you can just drag these effects into the green screen footage, then you can pick your own color to key out, as well as fine-tuning the keyer. In this overlay effects, we have this line art, like if you want to make your video look cartoonish, you can quickly do that with this one, where you can adjust the stroke and tone of the line art. You can also add some texture like halftone or line effects by turning on the preview area and adjust where you want the texture to be affected. Then for the pixel screen and the halftone overlay down below, these are basically the same as the title overlay. Reason I include it for two versions is because for the title version, it affects the entire screen. And if you want to quickly disable the overlay to see the footage without affecting other effects, you can simply disable by pressing D, which is faster than going into the inspector, compared to this one, where it is designed to let you use it with a specific thing, which you don't want the overlay to affect the entire screen. You can add these overlays to the title in this pack and create a unique texture for your own video. For the utility effects, these are all the effects that I wish DaVinci Resolve had them in their default open effects. First one is the outline border. It is pretty annoying when you want to create a border for anything, and the only choice you have is to go and do it in the Fusion page. So with this outline border, it allows you to easily do that in the edit page. You can adjust the input size in case your material is too big. You can add a border, you can add a glow, and finally drop shadow. Second one is 3D shadow. This one is similar to what you have in all of the titles. You can customize the shadow as you want, and you have the option to make the shadow glow. Last one, PNG color. This is also one of the effects that I really don't know why DaVinci Resolve doesn't include this as a default effect. You see, if you want to quickly change the color of, let's say, a logo or something, you have to do that inside the Fusion page. This one allows you to change the color of any logo or a PNG file to your desire, and of course without going into the Fusion page. You have the option to invert the mask and only affect the background, which is pretty useful when you capture a screenshot, for example, and it's not fully covered the entire screen. You can add these effects and invert it to affect only the background, then change the color to match the background of your screenshot. With this method, you can make a gradient color compared to a normal background where you only have one choice, which is a solid color. Creator Flow also has a lot of transitions ready for you, including the essential transition that I use the most, camera shake transition, perspective transition, slice transition, another creative one, and here are the samples. Now for the power grade here, we have the ones that increase the exposure, also with decreasing exposure for people who want to accurately adjust their exposure. Basically, these are all created with a linear gain adjustment, which your gain knob will work as similar to your global adjustment in the HDR panel. And it works the most accurate within a scene referred space, such as DaVinci wide gamut, aces, or camera log. To put it simply, if you want it to be accurate in terms of each stop increasing, you need to use this node before transforming it into a Rec 709, which is a display referred color space. Next one is the HSV adjustment, or another word, saturation. With this one, you have more control over your saturation compared to using a normal saturation knob. You control it by using your primary wheels. Basically, gain will affect the most on the most saturated part of the footage, lift will affect the most on the least saturated part of the footage, and gamma is in the middle. Let's say if you want to increase the desaturated part, but you don't want it to affect the ones that are already pretty saturated, you can increase the gamma and then decrease the gain adjustment to compensate that. You'll then get something like this, which you can see the colors that are already pretty saturated are not being affected that much. Then we have linear gain adjustment for people who want to fine-tune the exposure, if you need to, and for balancing the color. As we mentioned before, it will work similar to the HDR global adjustment. Now for people who don't have any ideas how to create a node tree for themselves, you can use this node tree. First thing first, you need to specify your input color space. So if you're shooting on a Sony camera, it'll be some kind of a S-log. Canon will be some kind of a C-log. Then the first node here is for controlling your highlights. If your footage needs any adjustment for the highlights, you can use this one to do that. Next is the exposure node. This is again the linear gain adjustment, which is for adjusting the exposure. Then the contrast node. This is for adjusting contrast and pivot point. Saturation, which is the HSV controller. Then we have a balance node. If you need it to balance the color, you can use this node to do that, which again is the linear gain adjustment. Next to it, we have a shadow node for controlling the shadow, in case you want to dial your shadow back a bit from when you're balancing the color. Normally, I will use the shadow knob in the log wheels to do that. Under that, we have the HSL, which is for fine-tuning the color that I want it to. Normally, I'll use the color slice or HSL curve here. Then we have all the power windows for the vignette if you want to create some. The bottom and the sky ready for you if you need it to. Then we have the curve node for someone who wants to dial their own curve. And then after you do all that, you can use the final adjustment, also with the final saturation, to do some final touch to your footage if you need to. Then we have a look node where you can apply LUTs or any kind of film look creator, or just use creator flow LUTs if you don't want to create it yourself. Lastly is the color space transform. Well, you obviously don't need to use all of the nodes every time. It really depends on each different situation, so you use it accordingly to your footage. If you cannot remember which tools control which adjustment, you can always read the document file attached in the folder. Now for our LUTs here, these are all designed to protect the middle gray of the footage, meaning it won't affect the exposure, only the contrast and the color tone. You can try and test it out for each different looks. Let's say sometimes if you shoot your video more biased to a warmer side, you may need to balance the color back a bit to get the most color separation. A lot of the times, it just depends on the set design. So try every LUTs and see which one works best for your footage, and then go back and further adjust accordingly. With these LUTs, you can of course lower the opacity of the LUTs if it's too strong. Or let's say if you want only the color tone of the LUTs, you can change the composite mode to color. It will then use only the color tone, and you can add your own contrast if you like. Or if you want only the contrast on the other hand, change the composite mode to luminosity. Or if you want to separately adjust the opacity between contrast and the tone, you can create a parallel node, one for the contrast and one for the color. You can then lower the opacity for each one as you wish. And once your looks is all set, when you want to further adjust the footage, you can do it before these nodes. And by the way, all of the LUTs here are designed to work in DaVinci wide gamut color space. Basically, you're gonna need to transform whatever camera lock you have to DaVinci wide gamut in order to make it look correctly. Then you transform it back to a Rec 709 afterward. Or if it's too confusing for you, you can always use the node tree that we have here. Just don't forget to change the input color space. Then you're good to go. And to summarize, all of these are creator flow. Thank you.